Welcome once again to the 5 Minutes with Franza series. I am your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. Today we will be discussing the discussion board in Blackboard. We're using Blackboard version 8. On the left-hand side, you'll see a button that says Discussion Board. Please click on it. The discussion board was created to help students and the professor communicate with one another. This is incredibly helpful in an online class where we don't have a normal dialogue going on. So, let's pretend that I'm a student and I'm logged in and I had a question about the Chapter 1 quiz. I would click on Chapter 1 and this brings me to the Chapter 1 forum. Since there are no threads here, I'm going to post a new one. We click the thread button here. We have something that we want as our subject. So in this case, I would say question 4 on the quiz. Remember, since the students and the professor cannot read your mind, you should give as much detail as possible. So in this case, I'm pretending I'm having a problem with this question. At the break-even point, the fixed cost equals the variable cost. I thought this statement was true. Can someone please explain why this statement is false? Once we post our piece to the discussion board, we click on the submit button. And here we go. Here is our question in the discussion board. If I knew the answer, I could reply to this piece and I get a new window that will open up and I can post an answer if I wanted to. If I had a file or something, I could also attach it. I would then browse my computer in order to find it. Once I had it, I would submit it. If I decided it wasn't something I wanted, I could click cancel. Also, a cute little note that you should be able to, that you should see, is I can flag things. So I check on a box and I set a flag. What this will do is this will make it easier for me to find later on. So if I thought maybe there was like a really good article posted or some really great tidbit, I would flag it. Or if I felt I needed to come back later to give more detail, maybe to help the student out. Also, you should note that you do have the advantage or the ability in Blackboard to not just put text or files. I can attach pictures, videos, QuickTime, Flash, audio files, Word documents. It really is feature rich. What I recommend to students when posting to the Blackboard is that you actually first type it up in Microsoft Word or some other word processing program, so that way you can spell check it, grammar check it, make sure that it is correct, then copy that and paste it into the discussion board. It'll make your postings look more professional and it will help people to help you. Thank you for tuning in and I hope that you found this video useful. Please look for other videos in the 5 Minutes with Franza series. Don't forget, when you're done with Blackboard, please log out. Thank you and have a good day.